Hello everyone, Treecks here. Welcome back to Arcade's Greatest Hits, the Atari Collection 1. It's always a bit difficult to actually remember how the game is officially called. Yesterday we actually did the first two games in this small little compilation title containing six Atari classics. Officially, there's also a part 2. It's the whole reason why this is called the Atari Collection 1. But I must already admit I only have the first one. And I believe there's also a Midway collection that released at some point. All of them on the SNES, the PlayStation and the PC, I believe. However, I'm going to be covering the SNES version. Those were a couple of small little things I could actually quickly mention. But anyway, the mentioning of stuff is actually done. It is time for us to continue playing some arcade titles. After Asteroids and Battlezone, we are going to be continuing with game number 3 and 4. And ever since starting this project, I've actually noticed... Strange that I actually never noticed before, but all of these games are actually in alphabetical order. It's A, B, C, M, S, T. It's actually in alphabetical order. How strange that I actually never noticed that before. So, I think it's actually enough introduction talk. We need more gameplay up here. Time for us to actually get started with a game called Centipede, and then we will follow up by also covering Missile Command. One of the few that I actually already knew before I actually got this game in my collection. But that one is going to come up second. We are going to get started with Centipede, a game I must say is one of my favorite ones to play from this compilation title. I think this is definitely one of the better ones. Let's see how this actually works. Of course, we're going to be checking out the game options first that the game actually gives us. Once again, we are able to choose how many lives we get to start. In this case, we can actually choose from 2 to 5 and everything in between. I think 5 actually sounds nice, because otherwise I'm going to game over way too quickly. There's a difficulty level in this game as well. We can actually choose from easy and hard. Guess what I'm going to choose? Like a lot of arcade games, this game also gives you the ability to get lives back. And the speed of the cursor. We're going to be seeing how that works momentarily. I think the game plays way too sensitively if we put it on max, so perhaps it's a better idea to stay a little bit below max and actually put it at medium speed. That way I think I have the best control over my little player, my cursor, or whatever it's supposed to be. We're shooting a centipede at least with something. This is how it works, as you can see. There's a couple of obstacles. In this case, they seem to be mushrooms. They're going to try to hinder our shooting of the centipede. That is obviously our main goal here. There's a centipede going downwards, and we need to shoot it. But be careful, if you actually shoot it in its middle, it will actually split up into smaller pieces, making it more difficult. And once the centipede is fully destroyed, we actually move on to the next stage. The number of obstacles can also be reduced by shooting them. As you can see, the moment we shoot these mushrooms, we are able to actually break them. As you can see, the moment we shoot the centipede, it will actually turn into a new mushroom. So shooting mushrooms in order to clean up the field is nice, but there's also a way for mushrooms to reappear. Also be careful for these spiders. They're actually here for extra hindrance. And later on, in later stages, they're going to move crazy fast, so they're going to be really difficult to avoid. I do love how every single stage we get a new color scheme. It's kind of funny to see, actually. Oh, we're moving down really quickly now. Yeah, every single time the centipede hits a wall, it's going to move down. And if the number of mushrooms is actually placed in such a way that they can immediately bounce downwards quickly. And then it can actually move really quickly towards you. But you don't really have to worry about dying the moment the centipede actually comes down fully. You are able to move your cursor up and down, so you're still able to avoid the centipede if it comes down all the way. But of course, it is going to be harder to hit him then. Because you also need to worry about avoiding. Kind of like what's happening now. Just single pieces, thank you. Next stage. Oh, this guy's here for bonus. Thank you. It's worth a lot of points, of course. Looks like centipedes all the way down. Extra life, thank you. 12,000 points, ow. Already had to use the extra life. Like I said, technically it is possible to still avoid the centipede the moment it's all the way down, but it is going to be difficult to do. Now reaching 13,000 points. still far away from an extra life, so... I'm not sure what... Oh! Wasn't able to actually avoid that. There was a mushroom above my head. Need to make sure to keep everything in my vicinity clean. Otherwise avoiding is going to be impossible to do. Oh, now it's really becoming difficult. Now we don't get a single piece centipede from the start. We're already small loose chunks right from the start. Oh, this guy again. Stop recoloring the mushrooms. I don't know what it is for. Perhaps you get more points for different colored mushrooms. You do get 1 point the moment you shoot the mushroom, of course. Well, you're going down way too quickly. Looks like the centipede no longer needs to use the walls or the mushrooms to actually go down. Get away from me. Oh, I'm taking too long. Yeah, as you can see, in the later stages, the centipede will actually automatically respawn. The moment you take too long, there's actually pieces coming from the side. Oh, come on! That is what I meant, stupid spiders. They move way too fast. Okay, easy pickings, thank you! It's getting really difficult now. Extra life! Love the jingle for that. Should sound familiar to you guys. Okay, this stage we've also got. This final one, or at least it was one final one, but it looks like we got it. Everything is plummeting down really quickly. I don't feel very safe over here. Ooh, nice. That's a good one. Thank you. Always wanted to crash into an enemy. There were a lot of broken mushrooms. As you can see, every single time you need to respawn because of losing a life, all of the broken up mushrooms are going to get refilled again. So, one extra life. Oh. Go away, you. This is going to be way too difficult. Need to go to the right. Yeah. Aggressive playing. It usually gets punished. I kind of had to because I was kind of running into a jam over there. Come on. Let's at least get this stage. Thank you. I have a hunch that this is going to be the stage that is going to get me. Let's see if we can get on 36,000. Get an extra life at least. Close. Come on. Yeah, also got this stage. Let's go 36,000. Stop missing. Gotcha. No. Okay. That was my extra life. And I don't have to count on another one. Let's go down in the glory. Let's make the most out of this. This final streak. Still alive. But for how long? I've also got this stage by the looks of it. Yeah. Not too sure how many stages I've cleared by this point. I've lost count a while ago, but... I have a feeling that I'm doing pretty nicely. Usually I don't get this far. Help! Okay, there we go. And this is also as far as I'm going to get. 40,000 points. Definitely not bad. Apparently I do have 2 credits left, but I don't think that really means a whole lot in a home title. That is really an arcade thing. Something this officially not is, of course, so... You're going to enter our initials, TRX, and apparently find out we are way better than the default scores, which is always good to see. At least we don't totally suck. And that is something we, in theory, could have actually done. Totally suck. I think we are actually done here. Press reset. And it's time for us to actually move on to game number 2 of today. And the fourth one in total. Missile Command. Just like Asteroids, a game that I did actually play at an actual arcade at some point. So I know what this game actually is. Even before actually playing this compilation title. It is pretty difficult, so don't think that because I know the game from a really long time ago that I are actually experienced enough in it to know what I'm doing. That is definitely not how it works. And for people who are actually big fans of movies, and especially the more famous movies, you might actually also know this game. Because, fun fact, this game is actually briefly shown in The Terminator as well. Terminator 2, to be precise, I need to say, because of course it's John who's playing there as a teenager. So, Terminator 2, he's actually playing Missile Command. But now I am going to be playing Missile Command, but not on an arcade, on a compilation title. Because otherwise I'm not going to be able to record. In this game we need to protect cities from missiles. And we are able to determine how many cities we actually have each stage. I think 6 is the default one. And once again, this is going to be a game where we're going to use a cursor. And this time an actual cursor. And we are able to actually determine how fast it will move. I think I will actually put the bonus at... Oh man, there's a lot of options here. Let's put it at 10,000. Sounds about good. It's easy to remember too. So, I think that's going to be it. Time for us to actually save a couple of cities from an alien invasion, because I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be an alien invasion. Alright, defend cities. We get the cursor. Some missiles are going to appear from the sky. And yes, that's going to be quite a few. And we need to use our missiles in order to try to protect all the cities that we see down here. As you can see, we have 3 missile depots. We can actually press different buttons in order to determine which ones we're going to shoot. And as you can see, my B button missile depot is already out, so we're not able to use that anymore. But we can of course also use the Y button and the A button to shoot missiles from the right or the left depot. And once we're done, all of our remaining missiles and cities will get tallied up, and that will actually determine our score. And then the next stage will start. Now giving us a new type of enemy. An airplane. Be careful, those can of course also shoot missiles, so make sure to take them out before they actually do, because otherwise you're just going to have more things to deal with. And I think you can already imagine this can get really crowded later on, and we also need to keep in account how many missiles we actually are able to use. These two, for instance, we can actually shoot 1 missile to destroy both of these, and that is something that's going to be required later on because of not having enough ammo otherwise. So, we better get used to how that works early on, otherwise you're going to be in a lot of trouble. And speaking of trouble, help! Alien invasion! As you can see, these UFOs also shoot new missiles. Just make sure the explosion hits them. The direct hit will not work on these missiles, as you can see. It's the explosion of our rockets that will actually destroy their missiles. And that way also clear this stage. Plenty of missiles and cities left. Next stage. When is this going to become too difficult for me? Trust me, it's not going to last very long. This I'm still able to actually deal with. Oh no! 1 city and 1 missile station out. 2 cities out. Okay, this is not going very well anymore. Lost 2 cities in 1 stage. We are able to actually get cities back the moment we reach the bonus score, which is 10,000 points. That is basically how the extra life system works in this game. The number of cities we have left, that is actually our extra lives. And I lost another one. The missiles actually start splitting up now. Ooh. Stupid plane, your fault. I've only got 1 missile left. Okay, this is going to be... Hell. Hell on Earth, help! Cannot stop this invasion! Oh, screw you. Oh, those things can actually avoid my missiles. Now it's really becoming too difficult. I've only got 1 more city left. At least it's going to be easy to defend. Oh. Never mind, I have to defend two cities again. That's the one plus side of not having a whole lot of cities left. We've got only one left, that is of course going to be easier to defend. Oh, and I've lost two of my missile depots. Need to defend that third one, and the cities of course. No! Oh, somewhere I really like this game. It's really hectic, really difficult. Because of the sheer panic that usually easily happens in a game like this, it's also really fun to do. Okay, missile station right out. Screw you, you're avoiding missiles. Gotcha. Got one more missile for you. Don't ask me how, but I am still alive. Background's become really scary now. These things start moving way too fast. I will defend at least two of my missile stations and the city. I will keep myself alive. And I'm out of missiles. The final two are not going towards the city, so I survived this stage as well. How long can the city stay alive? Stations out. We've got one left. And there goes the city. Yeah. It was unavoidable. It looks like this is it. Oh! I reached 20,000 points, so I get another city. Okay. Let's continue. What the hell? Oh, everything's out already? I cannot shoot anymore! Oh man. Now you see why I really love this game. It is difficult, but for some reason so fun to actually do. Time for us to enter some more initials. I believe my name was Treecks. And on an actual arcade machine that of course never fits, we always get three initials and nothing more. So, here comes the famous TRX. To input our score of 23,630. Which is three times better than all of the other ones that are preset on this cartridge. Let's actually try to go in again, because I've got some time left, I see. And that I can use to actually do a little bit of a play around. Actually show you guys how I actually like to play around in this game. And that is like this. The moment the stage starts, just immediately shoot everything you have. And hope that you actually hit as much as you can. Of course, usually that does not happen. So you end up with a lot of missiles that will still plummet down to the surface. And if you're lucky, some of your cities will still survive. In my case, half of them. Oh, this is not going to last very long, but this is just way too fun to do. Just shoot everything you have. Get everything before it even enters the screen. Oh, got a couple left on the X button as well, but not for long. I'm out of missiles. Now I need to get lucky. And it looks like I am not going to be lucky. Boom! The Earth is destroyed. This is the end. Just the way an actual sci-fi classic should actually do it. Well, that is usually a funny way to play around in this game. Not very practical if you want to get very far, but who cares about that? Anyway, that has been part 2 of the Atari Collection 1. Thank you all for watching. These have definitely been the more interesting games to play. Definitely more my favorites than the first two were. So, and this was a pretty fun episode, if I do say so myself. But next time, we still got two left. Super Breakout. A game that should look familiar, because it is of course based on another really classical arcade game that also has a variant here on the Atari collection. And then it's off to Tempest to finish things off, which is also one of my favorite games to play. So, that's going to be suiting for the finale. Next time, we are going to be playing those two. And this has been part 2. And I will say, Treecks out.